In this screencast, we're going to learn how to plot nonlinear equations. And what we're going to do is first linearize an equation and then use Excel's regression tool to plot them. So we're going to start with a rate law, and we say that K equals some initial rate constant times the concentration of A raised to some power times the concentration of B raised to some power. And what we're looking for is this initial rate, our M, and our N. And the reason we'd be interested in this is we want to put together a model. So given any concentration of A and B, we can find out what the rate is. So the first thing we're going to do is linearize this. So we take the natural log of both sides. So the ln of k equals the ln of k0 plus m ln of a plus n ln of b. Now, in order to solve this, we need to be given data for k when we have some a and some b. So let's say we're given k's are corresponding a's and b's. If you look at our equation, though, what we really need is ln of k, ln of a, and ln of b. And that's something that we can easily calculate in a spreadsheet. So let's take a look at this spreadsheet. And if you notice, we are given, we have our k, our a, and our b. And from that, we calculated ln of k, ln of a, and ln of b. Now we're going to go up here and look at our data analysis tools. And what we're looking for in particular is our regression tool. So the first thing that we do here is we input our y range. And again, you need to go back to our original linear equation. And if you notice, our y is going to be the ln of k. So our y range here is going to be this ln of k. Then the next thing that we want to put in here is our x range. And again, let's go back to our equation. Here we have two x's. We have the ln of a and the ln of b. So what we're going to have to do here is select both of those columns for our A and B ranges. Finally, we need an output range. And here, we're going to have our output range as A12. And once we do that, we hit OK, and we're going to end up with a summary output. So we're going to go back to A12 and take a look at what it says. So here we have a summary output. And the first thing we see are our regression statistics. Now, the closer the R and the R squared are to 1, the better off it is. And so you can see from this statistics that we have an absolutely perfect match. Let's go down further to our regression results. And what we see here is some more statistics, but the most important thing is what we see here, which is our coefficients. So this is our intercept, which is our ln of k0. This is our x variable 1, which is our m. And this is our x variable 2, which is our n. And one of the things that you can look at here to see if it is a good fit are these p-values. And if you notice, these p-values are very, very low. The lower they are, the more significant the coefficients that you got are. So let's go back now that we know these numbers. Let's go back to our original equation. So our ln of K0 is minus 5.68398. And again, let's go back and see where we got that. We got that from this intercept right here. So that's our ln of K0. But what we really want is K0. So that's e to the minus 5.68398. So our K0 equals 3.4 times 10 to the minus 3. Now we need our m and our n. So again, we go back to our Excel spreadsheet. Our m is this negative 0.5, so that let's put that in. And our n is this 1.23. So now we can put together our model. And what our model says is k equals K0, 3.4 times 10 to the minus 3, the concentration of A raised to the m power times the concentration of B raised to the 1.23 power. So that means that given any concentration of A and concentration of B, we use this model to find K, which is our rate.